Hello everyone, we're back with Super Meat Boy. So over the past few weeks, I've been looking to beat the game 106% without running. We obviously failed, but the total was something of like 42 run presses, which is kind of alright if you see that we collected 100 bandages. We had to clear more than 20 warp zones. We had to beat over 300 levels actually, so I'm kind of happy with that. But now I thought, can we push the limits if we use glitches? So for anyone who doesn't know what a glitch is, so a glitch is a sudden, usually temporary malfunction or fault of equipment, which basically means it's an error in a game or in a computer program or in anything. So I've been looking for some glitches and nothing is really useful, but there are some cool things that I want to show you guys. And the first thing is in the forest. There's just a really wanky hitbox. When I discovered it, I was playing as a kid, so I'm just gonna casually use him again. So we can stand up here. If you can see now, I'll zoom in for a second. I'm already standing into that saw, which is just really whack. Like, now I'm just inside the saw. It's stupid. It's just stupid, look! Well, no, this is not really a glitch, actually. It's more like a cool thing you can do. So, like... there we go. And now we're behind it. Which is just silly, because I don't know what Dr. Fetus is trying to hit. Oh my god, please. I remember why I was so happy when we were done with this game. It's hella frustrating. There we go. Good, okay. So now we just have to clear the level. Thank you. Thank you. But he's gone also. I don't know why that happens, but okay. So that's that. That's a little cheese trick. I think I explained what cheese is. Cheese is doing something not the intended way. Okay, next thing I want to show off is in the hospital, and a perfect example there for is level 8. Now what you need is you need a double jump character, so you know what, let's take Ogmo. The thing is, Ogmo has, from its own, he has 1, 2 jumps. Once he wall jumps, please, okay, that's a fail. If he wall jumps, he has 1, 2 jumps, 1, 2 jumps. Here's the weird thing. So this is just a one block wall, so every block on this, every block on this wall is one block thick, a block is just one thing, and he has one jump and a second jump. Now if you look closely here, this is half a block, because, this may be a good example too, this is half a block extra. And the weird thing here is the game thinks that you... I don't know what it thinks, but you get an extra jump. So here, this wall, you get 1, 2 jumps. This wall, you get 1, 2, 3 jumps. So your double jump comes here on the jump, the second jump, and here it only comes on the third jump. Which is weird. This is in every level with... semi-blocks or half-blocks, as I like to call them. It's cool for making long-distance jumps. It's not really a glitch, it's more something that wasn't really programmed very well. So the cool thing here is, if you look closely at the saws, the saws that are gonna fire, they just disappear around there. Like, I don't know if the hitbox still goes, Yeah, the hitbox just disappears. I don't know why you would go here, but it's not useful or anything. Everything I'm gonna show off is not useful in any way. There's still something cool, and it's with the brownie boss. I don't know if I showed that in my video, but basically what you can do is once you beat the boss, which I'm gonna do right now very quickly, whoops. So what you do now is you can just wait here, and then this happens. Now you are pretty free to go wherever you want, which is kinda cool actually. Don't know why this is useful. If you want to get an extremely long time, maybe it is. You also can fall down here. Now I need to look out for the salt. Yeah. The salt. If you want to beat it, you just jump to Brownie and the cutscene triggers and you beat it. And Hell has some really cool things with the lava that you can do. And with Meat Ninja. For the people of you who don't know who Meat Ninja is, you unlock him by getting, I think, 106% completion in the game. What he can do... Yeah, he disables things. Now I'm not holding R2, and he just already is running. Maybe I can showcase it in this... Oh yeah, there we go, look. Now... This lava kills you on instant, but if we time it right, we can actually... Please. Go through. You see that? So, boom, there we go. So all of this under here doesn't have a hitbox. The only thing that has a hitbox is the upper part of the thing. Now I don't know if we can get through that again. In all honesty. But it's still really cool to just see how that works. If we take Tim. That's Spelunky, that's not Tim. Where's Tim? There is Tim. So the way how Tim works is... Oh god. Tim works once you press square or R2, the run button, he warps back 3 seconds. And it's the same here, you can just do that, warp back 3 seconds, and now you're under there. The cool thing with Tim is that he's actually useful for this. So you can here just take, please. So, if you're having trouble with this and you want to beat the level with Tim and you realize, oh shit, I'm gonna not have enough time, just press R2, that happens, and then the cool thing comes. You can just keep holding R2 in that specific spot and beat the level like that, which is pretty neat actually. Ah, yes, so... So yeah, the portal doesn't really know what to do with me, and just keeps booping me. So yeah, if I just spam the button, some weird shit will happen. Tim can do something really weird with these black maws. So now there's one circling around, there's a second one, there's a third one. There's a fourth one, there's a fifth one, there's a sixth one, a seventh one, an eighth one, a ninth one, a tenth one, and more than 10 black maws are not able to get on the screen. But I mean, the portal, the spawner doesn't know what to do, so it just keeps spawning nothing. The screen is shaking like crazy, and once I release square, I'll basically just instantly die, which makes sense actually. So you hit the switch, and once you say, hold on, I want another attempt, this happens, and you're screwed anyway. Which is just really weird. Another weird thing is once you think, oh, I'm gonna need another attempt and you stay here, you're softlocked. What a softlock means is the game freezes in such a way that you can't progress, but the things are still, some things are still moving. So like Bandage Girl is still functional, the saws are still functional, but I am not able to move. What you need to do is you need to switch character or you need to exit the map, which is really shitty actually. And you just keep spamming square or R2, one or two. You will grab every key and you won't be able to die. So I'm gonna try and grab every key. So just like that, that's easy. And then we make our way to safety. So that's all really cool. We can jump and then, oh no, we're just gonna go back. So now this is free. Now we can take the bandage, we can go back. We can even say, oh, get juked, oh, get juked, oh, get juked, oh, get juked. Yeah, well, so I think these guys are called burned boys. These guys on my left. Thing with these guys is now they're not spawning, right? They're not running towards me. They jump with me and I can just progress the level, right? The moment I run towards one and I take it with me and I kill myself, or he kills me or whatever, but the moment I lure one of them towards me, he will chase me every time. So first it wasn't, and now it is, which is really weird, because that's the spawn things that they use. Okay, so another cool thing in this level, and I think I used that in my no run challenge, is instead of going through all of this shit and dodging that guy, you can just do this and walk over the mountain. It's like the most easy thing ever. You do that, they come here, you do this, that was really close, and you beat the level. You take Tim, and you know what we're gonna do. We're gonna press our little button here. We're just gonna chase this really gently. I don't know if it's possible with Meat Ninja actually, so let me try that for a second. Yep, it is. And now we can beat level. Then there is a little cheese trick in the boss. If you would be having trouble with all of this, the thing you do is you get on the platform. Let me do that again. You get on the platform. Actually, the cheese trick is harder than the real strat. Please. Oh. There we go. Then you just can stand here. The only thing that might form a threat are those white things. But you just have to, every time one comes up, just jump. And you're fine. Thank you. There we go. And that ends the boss too. Okay, so the moment, the moment the screen starts turning white, you exit the level, and once you exit once you enter a level again, you will see that the screen turns white, and then only starts. It's the white ending screen that still carries onwards through levels, which is kind of weird. one or another reason, I can only pull this off in this level. But the setup you want to use to have a frozen timer is you start the level and the timer will start running. You jump in a saw and pause. Press switch character. The level will start turning again. You resume game the moment it starts, and we were too late because the timer started. You die instantly. You press pause, switch character, level will start again. Now the timer is frozen. I don't know if it carries on. Now we beat the level with 0 seconds on the clock, and the timer will run actually. So that has no use whatsoever. Once we go back, the timer is still running. But it's pretty cool to have a clock on 0 seconds, I think. If we enter the Dark World level of 7-10, we can see, it's this one. There's something really weird. Normally you would go all around this and all that stuff. But if you just give up on life, just go through the floor and exit the level. Just like, bye. Hold on, let me lure the missile away. And then, so the way how this works is, yeah, I really don't know how it works in all honesty, but for example, it doesn't work there. It doesn't work on the upper one. I don't know how about what it is about the others. So for this, if you want to add an extra challenge, you could just go through and do all of this again if you really want to. It has no practical use at all, except that you'll just make it harder on yourself. You also can't go back through all of that, which is, you know, I don't know why you would use it, but okay. There's a little cheese thing. If you would be having trouble with this level, you just jump over these saws. So normally you would stay in between these, but you can also do that. And now you can take your sweetest time for every obstacle here. And you will still make it within the time limit. So that's pretty cool. The time limit is really generous. It's 60 seconds for almost all of these levels. There we go. We got a time of 20 something. Which is really useful, actually. No one ever thought, and not even the game developers, to make this wall solid. Because now I'm literally wall jumping on nothing, on invisible blocks. This has, again, no practical use. The other side has it as well. It's totally useless. You hit all these buttons. What if the wall in front of you closed and you had to kill yourself, right? There's a saw up here. And here's the problem. Buttons make you invincible. So if I'm standing on the button, I can't kill myself. If I'm not standing on a button, I can. It's really idiotic. You're standing here waiting on what you have to do, and that happens. And again, you can go back, but that just happens. So that's everything I have for you. I hope you enjoyed this little glitch video. That was all of Super Meat Boy I have to offer you. Yeah, I hope I see you at the next game, which is gonna be, you know, I'm not gonna tell that. I'm human enough not to tell that. But I have a lot of ideas, so stay tuned for that. All right, see you later. Bye.